That bloody bomber. I mean, the chamber was filled with irreplaceable treasures. Constable Oliver!
Don't move!
Put the pistol away.
Oh, you'd like that, wouldn't you?
Robert, be sensible.
Shut it!
What did you do?
I didn't do anything. But I'll tell you what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna arrest you.
Is he dead?
Just unconscious. Perhaps he can tell us who knocked him out.
Excellent.
Don't act all innocent. It was you.
I was in the treasure chamber with the director. You, on the other hand, had every opportunity to take the guard out.
I found him unconscious. I wanted to open the gates.
And make it easier for the Raven to escape?
That does it. On the floor. Hands behind your head.
Why aren't you in the embassy with Inspector Legrand talking to the press?
What are you talking about? Legrand refused to do it.
What?
He told the ambassador that he'd rather walk through the desert for 40 years than give interviews for 40 minutes.
We have to open the treasure chamber's gate. I suspect there's a secret entrance.
No. We should open the main entrance and call for help.
Robert, think. The Raven is inside the museum and so are we. We could catch him, but we have to give chase immediately. The two of us can finish it here and now.
You just want to confuse me.
Robert, I don't think you knocked this man out, but neither did I. I was with the director the entire time. Ask him.
That doesn't mean you aren't involved somehow. You could be working with the Raven.
So could you. We can suspect each other, open the exits, and offer the Raven every possible escape route. Or we can bring him to justice right here, right now.
Oh, okay. But just get this straight. I don't trust you. I'll keep an eye on you, and if you try to get away...
Understood. I'll try to open the gate to the treasure chamber now. I'd appreciate it if you'd refrain from accidentally shooting me.
No tricks, Zellner. And if we don't find anything in the treasure chamber, we'll open the gate at the main entrance and call Inspector Legrand.
Of course. A monitor. Probably for viewing the security cameras. There are 5 buttons down here, 3 of them labeled. Camera 1, camera 2, camera 3. This should be the one in the treasure chamber. As I expected, it didn't survive the explosion. Locked.
What are you doing?
I was looking for this. Blueprints for the museum. Every gate seems to be controlled by its own switch. This should be the gate for the treasure chamber. That's it. Dead.
Where do you think you're going?
I'm searching for a way into the treasure chamber, which is exactly what you should be doing.
I'll give you 5 minutes, then we'll follow my plan. Open the main entrance and call for backup.
Let's hope for both our sakes that I find a way into the treasure chamber before then. I don't want to be responsible for the escape of the Raven. That might help. It fits. All right. It has to work. Constable Oliver, could you lend me a hand? On three. One, two, three! Director Mokhtar, hurry! Put something under the gate!
Huh?
Director!
No luck.
It won't open any further.
Put it down, quick!
That'll hold it.
I wouldn't bet on it. We should hurry.
And inform Inspector Legrand.
First, I'll get an overview of the situation.
You don't think I'm going to leave you all alone with a jewel, do you?
I doubt that the jewel is still in the treasure chamber.
But how?
I'll be watching you.
Then you'll have to come with me.
If you haven't heard anything from me in 5 minutes, me, not Constable Zellner, then open the entrance and call for help. Understood?
Okay.
Let's hope that at least some of the artifacts withstood the explosion.
You don't want to go down there, do you?
That's how the eye left the treasure chamber.
Oh no, no way. We've seen enough. The Raven is gone. We need to get Legrand. Great. You happy now?
You could say that. Will you give me some light? Fortunately, the ceiling is quite high, and the gate was still ajar. Otherwise, nothing in this room would have survived the shockwave. The remains of the cordon. Give me some light. The clasps aren't really made for heavy weights, but I think they're strong enough. Not the best rope in the world, but it will have to do. I let myself down into the hole with the rope.
You can't be serious.
This isn't a matter for discussion. I'm going down there. You can join me or stay here.
But you don't know what or who is down there.
That's why I want to go down there. Besides, maybe I'll find an escape route for us.
All right then. Should I hold the rope?
Yes, thanks. I'm down. Give me some light, Robert. Shine the light over there, please. A map of Cairo. It's covered with hundreds of small holes, and there are some pins on the floor. There's a date in the corner, 1940.
There are cracks in the wall and scuff marks on the floor.
A secret door?
And probably the Raven's escape route.
Can you open it?
There are several panels and a kind of a handle, but I can't turn or pull or push it. Something's written here, but it's too dark. Hurry down with the light.
No, the Raven is trapped. We should call Legrand.
Do you think this door leads to a dead end? With every minute we hesitate, the Raven's trail is getting colder.
But we should take it one step at a time. We're alone and the Raven is dangerous.
What would Nicholas Legrand do in this situation? Would he wait for backup and twiddle his thumbs, or would he act?
Oh, blast.
Robert, this is our moment. Time to show them all. When the others arrive, they'll see that we didn't just dare to enter the basement. No, we also found an escape route and opened it. How do you think that will sound on the police report? Constable Oliver and Constable Zellner laid the foundation for the arrest of the Raven with competence and quick thinking.
Okay, here's what we do. I'll hand you the lamp and you open the door. Then we guard the door and wait for backup.
I couldn't have put it better myself.
Right. Catch, but hurry. I don't want to think about the fact that I'm standing here in the dark surrounded by mummies.
That's better. Is interesting. Four discs. An extravagant combination lock. If it was just another language with a Latin alphabet, I might be able to guess the meaning, but I'm lost when it comes to Arabic. I'll write them down. It could be a hint about how to open the door. What's that?
Hey, don't go too far away.
Come down and stop me.
Interesting. Some kind of wooden hatch. There are two hinges on this side. There's a kind of metal hook holding the hatch closed.
I'm the talking statue. I really like to teach bad words to the little boys.
At least that riddle is solved now. Peepholes. And I suspect... yes. The Raven couldn't have gone this way. We'd have seen him and he couldn't have closed the bolt from outside. I'm positive he escaped through the other secret door.
Why is it suddenly so bright down there?
I found the light switch.
What are you doing here? You are just...
I found another exit.
The eye?
Gone. The Raven blasted a hole in the floor of the treasure chamber. There's a hidden basement beneath it.
And the other treasures?
It doesn't look good.
Oh no.
Director Mokhtar?
Isn't it about time to open the gates?
I don't believe that the police have arrived yet. We can't risk giving the Raven a means of escape.
That monster is surely long gone by now.
Perhaps not. I have a lead.
Do your best. As soon as the police have surrounded the building, I'll open the gates.
Very well, Director. The basement below the treasure chamber. Did you know about it?
I had no idea.
There are maps and drawings from the Second World War in the room. Why?
Well, it may have had something to do with the resistance.
Resistance?
Egypt was occupied by the British. There was a movement for independence.
The Egyptians collaborated with the Nazis?
No, but the enemy of my enemy.
So, the rebels reported information to the Nazis, and for that, they needed secret command posts.
Yes, and what would be of more symbolic importance than the Egyptian Museum, witness to 5,000 years of Egyptian independence?
Hidden rooms? Secret basements? What are they doing here?
The museum was built in 1900 by a Frenchman who had a penchant for such things.
Mystical torchlight ceremonies celebrating the builders of old? Freemasons? Things like that?
Many great buildings have complicated histories.
And today we're going to write a new chapter. I found this Arabic writing. What does it mean?
It says, the sons of Horus.
And that means?
Is this really the time to discuss history?
It's important.
The sons of Horus played an important part in the burial ritual. Four sons, four canopic jars, vessels in which the liver, lungs, stomach, and intestines of the body were stored.
Are the four connected to symbols?
A man, baboon, jackal, and falcon. Look downstairs in the main hall.
Sons of Horus, vessels and intestines. Got it. It's going to be okay. Wait here.
Where is the constable anyway?
He's guarding the treasure chamber.
He told me to call for backup if he doesn't come back in about 5 minutes, and that I shouldn't trust you.
If you count on the constable, you're backing the wrong horse.
He's Legrand's man.
Did you ever think about the fact that he's the only one who was present at both burglaries?
Oh.
Must be the canopic jars the director was talking about. One jar for each of the four sons of Horus. Here we have Duamutef, stomach. The sign says Amset, liver. Hapi, lungs. Kebek Senuef, intestines. Kebek Sen.
Zelna, is that you?
It is I, the Raven.
Did you find an exit?
No, I'm still looking. The basement is quite large.
Okay, don't go too far away.
There we go. He's up there, Robert. I know that.
That may be. Go into the guardroom and open the gates.
Tell the director.
Zelna, don't do it. It's too dangerous.
You can't stop me. Not anymore.
Hundred steps at least. And a ladder. I'm too old for this. Left over from the war, if I had to guess. And why not? So high above the city is the perfect place for a secret radio installation. The chair is the only object that's not covered with dust. It seems like someone sat on it recently. Handcuffs. Not what I expected. Was someone interrogated here? Huh? The Raven, if I'm not mistaken. Why don't you step into the light? Mr. Inch.
Amazing. Truly amazing. I thought young Legrand would be my most dangerous opponent, but it seems I should have had more respect for age.
And the bomb on the train? Did you want to kill us all?
I knew that Legrand would be hot on my heels after the heist in London. He's a dangerous man, Mr. Zellner. He almost caught me once.
Is that a reason to resort to murder?
It wasn't my only reason. An eye for an eye, Constable Zellner.
What about the murder of the Baroness? Was that also your doing?
The death of the Baroness was never part of the plan. Dr. Gebhardt had a score to settle with her and got in my way.
You didn't care about the key to the safe?
I never wanted to steal the eye out of the safe. I always intended to strike here, in the museum.
What about Gebhardt's confession?
A nice idea, don't you think? It keeps the inspector out of my hair, for a few more hours at least, until everything collapses like a house of cards.
Why did you want to steal the second eye here?
The eye was in the bank in Zurich for a long time, impossible to get at. Then the safe on the ship in Legrand's cabin, too complicated. I heard about the secret basement and found out how the security system worked. I would have preferred to save my performance for the gala this evening, but, well, events demanded a change of schedule. Not least because of you, my nosy friend.
How did you do it? How did you plant the message on the safe in the train? How did you know that Gebhardt killed the Baroness and the demolition charge below the treasure chamber? How did you manage it all? Even if your arm isn't lame.
Oh, it is, believe me. I needed help, it's true. A messenger boy to replace my arms and legs.
A messenger boy?
Ah, Adil. This could be interesting. He's quite talented, but unreliable. He has a mind of his own plans. Don't you, Adil?
I never wanted blood to be shed, but it's time to make an exception.
He only forgot one thing. I keep things firmly in hand. Always. End of story.